That what he wanted to see?
Where does the man with 7 title belts and 3 weight classes live? Pensacola, Florida. Locals know it as P-Cola. So does the champ. He was born and raised here.
How y'all doing? Y'all all right? So y'all been enjoying yourself?
Yeah!
The good thing about this is, like, when you come and interact with other people that's doing something positive, it gives you a chance to keep yourself out of trouble. Because if you wasn't doing this, what would you be doing? Who knows? There's a lot of kids that don't get an opportunity to come out and do something like this. So y'all should make the best of it and make sure y'all enjoy yourselves, all right? Any questions?
How many years have you been boxing?
Titles do you all right?
What would you
do?
If you weren't able to box, what type of job would you
have?
Will you show us the move?
Why did you choose to be a fighter? Why did I choose to be a fighter? Because when I was a kid, I had a desire to fight, and I couldn't understand what it was. And I used to fight. I used to want to fight, but I wouldn't fight just for the fun of it. What I would do was, even in elementary school, if I saw a bigger kid picking on a smaller kid, that was my chance. So when I used to go around the school, I was the police. If I catch you picking on somebody, we gonna fight, because that's what I've been waiting on anyway. I just like the competition, because the whole while I would fight, I would be laughing. I never get mad at people. I just fought because I wanted to fight, to see how good I could be. So my dad started teaching me to fight. That's what it was. But I really thought from watching Muhammad Ali, Joe Frazier, that I could outthink people. And boxing was more mental than physical. A lot of guys got in boxing because they thought it made you tough or was a mean. It wasn't that for me. For me, I thought that if you use your mind, outthink the next guy, you could beat him. But my biggest advantage is my speed. So when they can't keep up with me, then they can't beat me. Jail too fast, though, you know what I mean? I think they got this going again. Ooh, shit, I'm fast. You know what I'm saying? Get these grills off before I do something. I hurt something, man. Not bad. You know you're getting old, about to retire. You got to get your own clothes. Getting fine for the fall.
It's got nice abs.
Women say they like when you're fine.
Very sexy. Very sexy.
Try to stay fine for the fall. Every time I fight, I gotta get fine away. Otherwise, I'm a fat boy.
Okay, right on my
phone.
Where you want to tune in?
Shut up.
Yes, I'm somewhat a sex symbol. I must say that because I guess over the years, my body developed into something that women like to see. So, of course, if you're a decent looking, if you're a good looking man and you got a good looking figure, why would you not be a sex symbol?
Right about now, yeah, he the man.
Could be getting a little lazy. My old age, I don't know. Don't be having much to prove no more, you know, so. I don't know, I could be a little bit. But I'm still dangerous. So you can call me lazy, but I'm dangerous and lazy, so.
You got Champ Waters. Let him out. Move that ladder, man. Come on, faster. Come on, big punches, man. Big punches. Change over. I don't know who brought him out. Move that ladder out the way.
I'm human, just like the next person. Just that I studied my job. I was taught a very good foundation by my father. I know what to do in pretty much every situation. There's no situation you probably can put me in that I have never been in inside the ropes. So your only chance to catch me with a good punch is to get lucky and knock me out, because I'm going to be in shape every time. My mind going to be right every time. I love to fight. Love it with a passion.
He wears you down. He wears your body down. After that, here come all that strong stuff. Then it's like, then you sleep. Looking for the MG squad. Somebody help you up. Smelling sauce, whatever. It's crazy, man. And one day I was playing with her, and this was just strictly playing. I was seeing all types of marks on my arm. I was like, man, what are you doing? I mean, his fist was on my arm. I was like, man, I don't even want to fight you no more. And it hurts, man. He just keep beating on you, man. I'm not going to lie. And then, you know, people ask you, they say, do you spar with Roy? I say, no. I straight up tell them no. They say, why? I be like, are you crazy? You think I want to get into a match with this guy? Come on.
You play a chess, but you already showed me your move. You said the first time I do this, that first, see what I'm saying? He'd never get a right hand off. Okay, so I go, 1-2. Ain't no way in the hell he gonna get there. It ain't no way in the hell. By the time he get there, I should be so damn fucked on. You to call somebody to find out where I'm at.
If Roy can actually put on 200 pounds and still be that fast, you know how many heavyweights would be in trouble? Can you imagine that? I wouldn't even be looking at it. I'm retiring, y'all. I wouldn't even be trying to fight him, man. Not at all. I don't want to fight him now. I say, here go all the belts. You want him? You want him, you can have him.
Sure. How you doing?
Can you say fine? Yeah. Right next to your Scooby-Doo poster. See, you rank up there with Scooby-Doo.
He said that.
Come on, bro.
What I do here in Pensacola, the same stuff I would have did if I wasn't Roy Jones Jr., the boxer. I'm still Roy Jones Jr. I'm still the same person. So giving back to the community is something that I would have tried to find a way to do had I not been successful. Come here. I got a deal for y'all. Come here.
Yeah.
Y'all, it's three of y'all. Y'all kick his ass and take it.
Hey,
ain't no
birthday.
Kick his ass and take it. Matt, this is supposed to be limo driver, but he ain't driving too good lately. Okay, this been a long time for him. Now, you can't find a better friend. Just you probably can find a lot of better drivers, but you can't find many better friends. You know? The reason this guy is so funny because he proclaims to be the best driver.
I'm the best. I'm still the best.
You see where I'm coming from?
I am still the best that ever walked around through here driving any kind of limo or 18-wheeler.
He can't drive nowhere. Ain't going nowhere. He let people run into my truck. Nah, I ain't messing with him. Hey, look, hey, trust when they take the camera off, I'm going to see you.
Tell me you want to go over there and watch the home run. We'll get it.
Y'all kick his ass.
We'll get it.
Y'all tear his ass. Y'all tear his ass.
Matter of fact,
y'all beat him good. Because he argued with the old lady and hit him. Y'all beat him good.
He beat him good.
Y'all take that shirt off of him. Matter of fact, when y'all take the shirt off, he hit a run.
Why did you do
come
that?
On. I thought you were about to set it off.
Oh, man.
Is that nice?
That's what I'm saying. Yes, sir. Man, it's a beauty. I wonder when you're going to drive this bad boy here.
The Harley, man, it's like the Harley is the bike of all bikes.
Life is presented to you by Sprite. Obey your thirst. The life is presented to you by Sprite. Obey your thirst.
How many you got since I've been gone?
Oh, tell me how many we had.
Yeah, just put him on the ground.
How many you got since we got?
No, that's it. We just had another one. Mama had a beautiful fish.
Yeah, you got all
Spanish mackerel. Oh,
that's my fish.
That's what a favorite.
That's what we caught before we got here.
That's right. I was going to say, that's the one you hooked up on.
All right, you rigged up, bro. Back up through the head.
They do.
That's it. You on.
Damn it.
Fish.
I happened to go down here where I seen him running at. Hey, what's up? What y'all got out here?
No, he's hung up. That's hung up.
Okay.
I don't want to kill the one that wounded that fish.
Go ahead, go over to my spot for a minute. Let's see what happened out there. I should be on some TV show as good as I am. Yeah, man, you catch a lot of variety right here, you know? Big variety of fish caught right in here. Oh, they was. He got my bait, I think.
This is relaxing. See, fish.
Yes, it is.
We don't get to relax as much. When you sit down and relax, you get gray hair. Uh-oh. I feel them coming already.
I've been relaxing all.
Bill been my friend, probably the longest friend I've had outside of boxing. And all everybody that knows Bill knows that Bill don't drink, Bill don't smoke, Bill don't do nothing. But that's why Roy and Bill have been so close for so long, because they, my positive impact really affected his life. And it has him in a much better position today than he would probably be in.
That's what we need to be doing right there, some jet skis. Don't fall.
Yeah, I try to fish about twice a week when I can. And when I'm in town, I try to fish twice. Actually, when I'm in town, I try to go out almost every other day.
Is that right?
Yeah.
It's
relaxing. Yep, I love it. It's like my little fishing house. It's like, I don't know. For me, it's like where I get away at. It's not the mansion. It's not the ranch. It's like, it's more like my training camp. And when I'm in training camp, I love to fish every day, so I just can walk down here to the water and walk back up here and chill. I got a gym right here on the inside, the boxing gym. I got stuff to keep myself physical fit for whenever, even when I retire. Love to fish. Bear comes. Very, very, very entertaining to me. Get your mind right fishing, you know? But we're going to let this guy live. I don't have no need for him, so we didn't live. One more, boy. Okay, brother. I just got to get me a stranger.
Let me move. I done seen too many comedians show people be hooked in a clip.
Now, I think it'll calm down a little bit now. I like living on my own. If I want to come out here and fish all day, I want to be able to do that. I don't want nobody controlling me. How can I teach my kids to be men and control their own destinies if I let somebody control me? Then what type of an example am I setting? Really, if I had my fishing rod in my hand right now, I'd be very happy. Is there more knowledge, or he lying? Is he lying? I can't tell if he's alive.
Before you leave.
Alive.
Huh?
Alive.
Yeah.
I said, this fishing stuff is kind of like a good woman. It'll have you hooked.
But it also causes you pain. Look at that.
Look at here. You got to pay the price when you catch a spaniel.
What in the world?
Eat you up. You didn't see the teeth on that spaniel?
Oh, they got you like
they
that?
Eat you. Sharp as Roy Jones Punch. Spanish man. Beautiful fish.
My main thing when I'm training is to keep myself calm-headed. And to stay calm-headed, need that reel in my hand. Fishing, chilling, got him, know what I'm saying? So when I get in the ring, got him, know what I'm saying? So fishing really kind of prepared me for fighting, because it's all calm. Then all of a sudden, you got something, know what I'm saying? But when I be fighting, it'd be all calm. I got something. Very close, but yet so far apart.
The life.
Oh my gosh!
You think he's sick in the ring? Check out his semi-pro skills on the court.
Still wonder why.
They call him Wyatt Earp. He shoot everything.
It depends on what we're playing. He passed to me.
That's my dog. I ain't
going
to talk about him.
He finally learned to pass because he don't pass. Somebody, one out of two.
This guy
right here,
if you got points, a bad shot is better than a good pass.
He averaged 100 a game.
Yeah.
One out of two got a pass. So Jones turned into the pass.
Jones like to play with four people who know how much he want the ball.
Damn, hiding her today. I ain't been out here so long. I ain't been playing and training hard. You watch train hard, throw my shot off, but I don't play every day. When I don't feel like boxing, when I don't feel like being in that boxing environment that I've been in for the last 23 years, I can go to the basketball gym, get the same everything out of you, get the same competition, just as good a workout. Get to be with my friends on the same level as an everyday, ordinary Joe.
The Donald Bates, my slam dunk champion right here, I told you about. FBI is about the longest sprint I had
Here comes Cola. That's Freddie Cole. That's the score right there. Freddie Cole get the job done. Anybody in the two positions, Freddie Cole get the job done. That B-Love, that's one of my old time homeboy right there from old school, you know?
You guys ever lose, man?
Yeah. We did back in like, they was 89. But we only had three people.
Yeah, right before the goal ball.
Mm-hmm.
Really? Like, we had this fire right here, or even on competition day, nobody won't beat us.
Yeah, okay, I heard about that.
Let's go, boy.
Just beating up on the local basketball team,
yeah,
pretty much. And the Navy base too, which has been seen today. But we still love them.
Yeah, number love, you know.
Yeah, you know.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
They do a better job of fighting for the country than playing ball. They ain't gonna let us come here and win every game.
They don't like that.
They mad.
They don't like that at all. They go home, they have drill team discussions about this, they don't play that.
They ain't gonna drink this weekend.
I'm saying, and smoke neither, ain't nothing bad this weekend. Try to keep up with them. But see, how you promote good health. You come out here and you tear their ass up and they realize, you know, them guys don't go out and party and drink every weekend. They do their business and get back in. So that's why they be beating out behind, you know, and they know that. So next week they say, we're gonna cut that stuff out. We wanna keep up with them. So they'll come back and play harder. Won't do no good, but you know, at least you'll try. You know what I mean?
No tolerance.
So it's all good. Them guys know I'm coming to the gym, they'll come. Why? Because they know the champ out there to win. That's going to make them play harder. Because the champ coming at you, and whoever he bring with him, they're going to be at you too. Because they don't want to lose. They want to look good for the champ. But other guys want to see, can they challenge? They can't challenge the champ in boxing. But it's fun for them to say, hey, I played basketball against him. You know, so we beat him in basketball. I mean, that gives them something to brag about. Don't bother me, but I ain't going to let you win too much.
This is a helicopter just in the running room.
The Life is presented to you by Sprite.
The Life.
Obey your thirst.
The Life.
Total Access is brought to you by Levi's Jeans.
We know RJ in the ring, but at home, he's just a country kid that prefers to keep it simple.
See my little boys, you know, Roger, Sean, Andre, actually seeing kids, period, enjoy themselves, but to see mine enjoy themselves on things that I was able to get for them makes me happy.
Good job.
Trey, what's up, Trey?
Yeah.
How you living?
Good. I ain't think you coming.
You ain't think you coming? What's up, DeLon? What's the deal?
Well, you know the old cliche about you can take the country boy out of the country, but you can't take, you know, take the country out of the boy? Well, that's going to exist with Roy. You know, as long as he live, I'm sure.
See, a lot of people don't understand this country living. Teach a lot of responsibility. Give the kids something else to do. Give them something to make them proud of, you know. They got their horse, take care of their horse, know how to feed them, take care of them. It's good for them.
It's haircut time, you know that?
Huh?
I said it's haircut time. Huh? Being home, looking through the chicken yard, riding the horses, fishing, just hanging with the kids, doing whatever, you know. That's what makes me happy. I'm good.
Hey, he used to walking horses. Walking horses are a lot different, you know, it's more like Cadillacs. It's just a quarter horse style right there.
Ooh. Kind of crazy. You got some good kicks in, don't you?
Good. Keep going. Good. Tap on that. This outside here. Tap, tap, tap.
I used to be pretty good. Ooh, boy. Come on, let me see something. Dang. Well, you found somebody to pitch you up.
It's just that I ain't brushed it in a minute.
Okay, well, they like y'all ain't brushed it in quite a minute.
So?
See, y'all got exclusivity.
exclusivity. Nobody got my dad on camera. It's the first time that me and him went somewhere together in about 10 years. And y'all got it on the life. So don't say I ain't never do nothing good for y'all, all right? I know a lot of people talk bad about me, but don't listen to it. It ain't all true. I do good things.
The life. The life.
J-E-T-S. Jets, Jets, Jets.
Well, I can't believe he was in the league. He's still in the league. Playing. I'm just coaching.
Next week on The Life, New York Jets head coach Herm Edwards. Nah.
That's the same thing Bernard Hopkins talking a bunch of crap. See it on the ground right there? That's what he's talking at, what he is. You don't want to fight me. You're talking that right there. That's what I'm saying.
For more information, log on to ESPN.com, keyword, The Life.
See that boxer down there? I think his name is Bernard. I told him I'm a better boxer.
The Life.
Everybody, get on your feet,
Roy Jones Jr., the best pound for pound fighter in the world. Whoever don't agree, you know what? I guess
y'all must have forgot. When they stole my gold medal and sold career, let's look back at my whole career, cause y'all must have forgot. For pound is mine. Hit Percy Harris with four hooks at one time.
Y'all must have forgot.
When I beat Bernard Hopkins and won the IBF, the right was hurt, beat him with the left.
Y'all must have forgot.
You remember the left hook that James Tony got? Sucker move I stole from a Gamecock.
Y'all must have forgot.
Will it be another Roy Jones? Probably not. With a body shot.
See, y'all must have forgot.
I got disqualified in March of 97 after giving a whooping to Montel Griffin. Late hit, my title, they had to take it.
Why?
I guess that's the only way I could lose. 5 months later, rematch, I need my crown. First round, one punch, and he sat down. Don't get me mad, cause I'm amped already. Took titles from fighters who were champs already. The heart and soul of boxing on HBO. What these other fighters take me for?
A y'all must have forgot.
And they got the nerve to say, I ain't fight nobody. I just make them look like nobody.
Y'all must have forgot.
Telesco, he really asked for it, so I beat him with a fraction wrist. See, y'all must have forgot. In the ring, I box. There is none higher. When I use these, they call me sire. To earn my kingdom, I must lose fire. And I won't stop boxing till I retire. I'm Roy.
Y'all must have forgot. Y'all must have forgot.
When I beat Reggie Johnson, took his light heavyweight title from him. See,
y'all must have forgot
that I'm nice with these. This is what I do.
Y'all must have forgot.
We could go on and on. Mike McCallum, Vinny Pazienza.
So y'all must have forgot. Y'all must have forgot. Y'all must have forgot.
Problem making weight. Clinton Woods, there he is at 174 pounds. Roy Jones Jr. coming in spectacular condition, as usual, 174 and a half. All the makings of a tremendous mismatch. The tale of the tape brought to you by Miller High Life. And here we go. Now, Roy Jones, 33 years old, talking about heavyweights. He's going to try to move up there. This guy's 5'11".
I could talk about heavyweights, too. I talk about heavyweights every week, but
it's a different story. And here's Clinton Woods. Now, you're saying, oh, I really don't know this guy. It's because you really haven't seen him fight anybody stateside. He's won 13 straight fights. Yep, his first fight in the United States. So it's a 100-to-1 odds. Roy Jones, once again, a heavy, heavy favorite. Well, we're now joined by the light heavyweight champion of the world, Roy Jones Jr.
Roy, thanks for being with us, taking a few minutes after your weigh-in. You tell me, you're fighting a guy like Clinton Woods. Have you seen him on tape? Have you ever seen him fight before? Do you do any studying at all on this guy?
Yeah, I saw a little bit of him on tape. Looks pretty okay, but the thing about these guys is you never know who's going to show up. They're suspicious. You never heard of him before. He just has everything to gain and nothing to lose, so, you know.
Roy, not to look past Clinton Woods, but I got to look past Clinton Woods here for a second. No, we understand, Brian and I haven't forgot. You can't say y'all must have forgot. We both got you number one pound for pound. But here's some criticism. You respond to this. Understand you don't want to go to Germany fight Mikulchevsky. You don't want to fight Bernard Hopkins. They're playing games in negotiation. There's Girov. You're not going to make much more money for that. He's a bigger guy. People ask a lot of you. What about Antonio Tarver? You finally got a real legitimate contender and threat in your division. When are we going to see you fight Tarver?
Next, if it's able to happen. But the only thing is that people have been complaining about my opponents for some while now. And my thing is this, Max. If you get to be number one contender, I got to fight you. I got to keep my title. So if you're number one contender, I don't care what your name is. If it's Antonio Tarver, Bernard Hopkins, Darius Mikulchevsky, whatever your name is, if you're the number one contender, I got to beat you. Okay. They already got under contract what it is. Ain't no negotiations, ain't none of that. Ain't no taxes about that. You get to be number one, and you deserve a fight against the champ. It's that simple. I'm the light heavyweight champ of the world. If you get to be ranked number one, you can fight Roy Jones Jr. It ain't about all the negotiation tactics. It ain't about all the other stuff. Antonio Tarver, the only thing between me and Antonio Tarver is John Ruiz. If I get an opportunity to fight John Ruiz, the WBA heavyweight champion of the world, and it's good, and the money's right, and it's a nice event for me to go challenge for that title, I'm probably going to go
do
that
first.
But Roy,
let me say what the cynics and what your critics will say about the Ruiz thing. They'll say every time Roy Jones is faced with maybe a potential dangerous opponent, he starts to flirt with some heavyweights to distract us, then that fight doesn't come through, and he goes back to fighting mediocre light heavyweights. How do you respond to that?
They can say what they want to say. I have never had an opportunity to flirt with a heavyweight champ of the world to this day. So I have never flirted with fighting nothing but a heavyweight champion. I didn't even think twice about the Buster Douglas situation because that was a no-win situation for me. If I beat Buster, what am I at? What am I now? Stuck at heavyweight? No, that was nothing for me. The only thing I would move to the heavyweight division for is for the title. Other than that, I wouldn't even be going to the heavyweight division. If I don't fight John Ruiz, it's definitely Antonio Tarver. It's no negotiations. He already number one contender across the board. After this fight, it's John Ruiz or it's Antonio Tarver. That's something.
Roy, how about Bernard Hopkins then? Is that all over?
You know what? I don't even want to talk about that because it's like people been yada, 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 Hopkins. If I was in that position, matter of fact, when I was in that position, when they robbed me, when I got disqualified for my title, my first thing was, I don't care what it takes, just get him on the other side of the ring so I can prove to the world that he cannot beat me. That's a man that knows or got a lot of confidence in the fact that he can win a fight. Now, when you go out there and say, yeah, I can beat him, but I want 10 million. Oh, you don't want to beat me. You don't really want to fight. You want to make a payday. Let's get it understood. We ain't stupid. Everybody ain't stupid that's they complaining or acting like they are. They ain't that stupid. If you want to fight me, it's simple. You can be number one contender or take 60-40. You lost one time. 60-40 is fair for you. I mean, why? I don't even have to fight you. You ain't even in my weight class. You've been winning at one weight class. I left that title there for you. I left. I moved up and left that. After I beat you for it, I left it to go do bigger and better things. Now, why do I have to be running from him? Is he crazy? What kind of sense does this make? I don't understand where people get their logic from, but I am the light heavyweight champ of the world. I don't even have to explain myself no more, man. It's just that if you want to fight Roy, get to be number one contender. I'll see you when I see you.
Roy, thank you so much. We enjoyed it. Thank you, Roy. Good luck tomorrow night.
Uh-huh.
That's a shame to see that come to an end.
Entertaining.
Enjoying that. He had all the things covered. Yeah. Now, people will be shocked if Clinton Woods lasts even a couple of rounds in this fight. Here's what you said on ESPN.com. Roy.